Welcome to another inspiring message with Pastor Deborah Bell from Deo Gloria, South Africa, as she brings you a word from God.
Hallelujah. Lord, let your Holy Spirit come and move among us. Praise God. So we're on a new direction, and this is part four. And we said in the previous messages that we must rely on faith, not feelings. Because we know that our feelings can tell us one thing one moment and another the next. And if we're relying on our feelings, we're going to be like the Israelites when they went in the desert. And we're going to end up almost going a complete circle when we're just on the verge of entering the promised land. And your promised land tonight might be that very amazing gift, that life partner that the Lord has for you. It could be that new job that the Lord has for you. It could be entering into a new season of your faith where you're moving to the next level. It could be all sorts of things. And it's just around that next corner. But what happens so often is when we rely on our feelings, we end up believing those beautiful promises and hopes and not entering the promised land, not entering into the next dimension of what God has for us, because we're relying on our feelings and we're relying on the next thing, which is what people say. And the only voices that we are supposed to be relying on, according to the word, are voices with the three C's. And the three C's are what? Credibility, consistency, and consecration. You're looking for people that are living holy lives, not just talking about holiness, but people who you can see Jesus Christ is living in, and that their lives are congruent with the lifestyle, because this is a time where we can use lifestyle, because lifestyle is a choice. Amen? Remember, your sexual orientation isn't. And so, it's so wonderful because we learn that we can rely on voices where we see Jesus Christ in that person, and more than that, not just this person that has Jesus Christ in them, but that they are living lives that are congruent with that. In other words, it's an ongoing thing. There's a consistency in their lives that shows and proves that this is who they authentically are. There's a credibility in their lives. There's a track record in their lives. This is somebody that you can really look up to spiritually. A person that can offer you wisdom that is not because of any hidden motives or any hidden agenda, or because it makes them feel better to offer you wisdom, or whatever it is, it's because they are people that you can trust and learn to trust. And so if we're listening to the wrong voices, we're going to be like the Israelites. Because when they listened to the wrong voices, what happened when Moses was up there praying and interceding for them and hearing from God and getting the Ten Commandments and doing all those things? What were they doing? They were building golden calves. Whose credibility you uphold. And so we deprive ourselves of the very blessing, or we actually hinder ourselves entering the promised land, that place of blessing, that place of wholeness, that place of fullness in our lives. Because so often we're listening to the wrong voices, and we end up going round and round in the desert places instead of entering into the promises of God, which are what the whole thing is about. And it's not just the land of Canaan, which is heaven. We're talking about the promise of God, that even on this earthly life, which for us can be very long, even though it's very short. When you get this side of 40, you realize it's short. It's much shorter than you think. You know? But it's okay. When you're living a life in Christ, that's a good thing. You might get a few spare tires and stuff. And that's also not a good thing, because we're supposed to be kind of looking after everything, not just our minds and our spirit, but our bodies. Amen? I'm trying to be a good example of that, but you know, there's all sorts of other things that come into the picture, and God's dealing with me. But the truth of the matter is that when it comes down to it, we cannot rely on our feelings. It'll lead us back into the desert, because our feelings can move one way and the next way, and they're up and they're down. We don't live and make our decisions on emotional highs and lows. If you do that, you're living in a very dangerous place, because you will not be congruent, you will not be consistent. You live your life based on the consistency of this word. And so even when your emotions are down there, and even when you are feeling in the worst possible place, you've just heard a great message about faith. You've just heard how you can be in a place of brokenness, how you can be in a place of torment, and yet there is hope, and yet there is a future. Because when you're sitting in church and you're hearing the word of God, it brings you hope. There is always life. And the Bible says that the word of God is active and alive, and it's sharper than any double-edged sword. And it has the power to separate good from bad. It has the power to give us discernment as to what is right and wrong. It has the power to give us the wisdom to move in on the right direction of our lives, even when we're feeling in a vulnerable place emotionally. God speaks to us in the small, still voice. People that we look up to speak to us with a godly wisdom, and we begin to move not based on our feelings but on faith. We begin to hear the right voices, and we move in the new direction. You and I cannot be sustained, and that's what we're talking about tonight. We cannot be sustained in the new direction, the course that we move into when we find Christ. We cannot be sustained without those things. Living by faith, which incorporates many things. It incorporates your quiet time with Jesus Christ, your prayer time, your reading of the word, your hearing of the word, your teaching of the word over your life. It incorporates hearing the voice of the Holy Spirit. It incorporates listening to godly wisdom from those that you believe can offer that to you. It incorporates all those things, because you and I, when we base our decision-making process on our emotions, it's very, very dangerous. 2 Timothy 3:5 says, some people have a form of godliness but deny its power, and they are the ones that are always learning but never able to acknowledge the truth. Can you see what I'm saying? Sure, Pastor, that was a great message. Amen. 2 days later, hit the floor. Now, there's nothing wrong with hitting the floor when you're living out your life in faith. We can still be broken, and we can still, you know. But we can't keep hitting the floor in the same place. You can get to the next level and hit the floor there and get up and shake the dust off your feet and move on. Are you with me? But you don't want to keep hitting the floor in the same place, because then you want to notice that it's going, amen, what a great sermon, what a great message. Oh, the Holy Spirit spoke to me this week. This is what I learned. And you know, I just love being a Christian. We've got to be careful that we don't move into a place of religiosity, and that we are staying authentically a people who are living out our belief system in Jesus Christ, which is based on faith and not my feelings. My feelings are deceptive because I cannot be objective about myself. How many know that? You just have to study a little bit of A-grade psychology and you'll understand that you cannot, absolutely not, under no circumstances, be objective about yourself. And that's why it's great to have very, very good friends around us. That's why accountability is such a big thing in the church today. Because we can learn so much more in an accelerated point of view about ourselves in a healthily constructive way. Healthily constructive way. That can grow us and move us to the next level. With little chaos. With little detriment. With little fuss in our lives. Will we not making so many mistakes? Amen?
Amen?
So we asked ourselves the question last week, are you a God pleaser or a people pleaser? So when someone says something contrary to the word of God that you've been taught, you've got to make sure you turn your back on it, not embrace it. Otherwise you may go in the same direction. That's what the word of God says. And so then the third point that we discussed last week was staying the course, and we looked at three observations. And I know I've just preached a mini sermon that wasn't in the previous week, but that was just obviously the Holy Spirit. But the third point was stay the course, and the three observations were that the disciples were devoted. They devoted themselves to the teaching of the word through the apostles. It says they had constant fellowship. And we took that out of Acts chapter 2:42, right? Somewhere there. They had constant fellowship. And the third thing, the third observation, was that they had covenant relationship. And then the fourth point I want to make about how to stay on course. It really formed part of staying on course, but just for want of cleaning this up a bit for the last split in the series, is the fourth point is having God encounters. And it's all really under how we stay the course, how we sustain our walk in Christ. And some of that I've shared a little bit about with you. And I want you to turn with me in your Bibles to Acts chapter 9. Because tonight we're going to talk a little bit about the man, Saul, whom you know as Paul. And we can do a kind of hip-hop thing about that. So having God encounters. Now, what does that mean, having God encounters? This is all about transformational biblical faith. This is about transformational biblical faith. You and I cannot sustain ourselves unless we've had a God encounter. The first God encounter you have is when you give your heart to Jesus Christ. But that's not the only one you are meant to have. Otherwise, you become stagnant. Instead of one that's moving to the next level of where you need to be. So it's all about transformation. Transformation is that process where you are changing, where you are having a spiritual metamorphosis going on, and you are moving from the old into the new. And that's exactly what the whole point is about. You can't hold new wine in old wineskins, because the Word of God says that it will break. You have to have a new wineskin with new wine. And so when you come to Christ, not only do you need the new wineskin, but then you need the new wine. And the new wine is the renewal of yourself in taking in this Word of God and beginning to transform into the likeness of Jesus Christ. And we cannot do that without making space. There's a whole lot of stuff that has to come out of ourselves that has taken hold of us from the old. And you know, it's not like God takes everything at once and throws it out and says, okay, now fool me with yourself. When we give God permission. Because God knows that we can only deal with what we are ready to deal with at any point in time.
You have been watching Pastor Deborah Bell from Deo Gloria, South Africa.